गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे टॉपिक इज कॉरोशन। ओके, व्हाट इज कॉरोशन? द जनरल टर्म, एज पर द जनरल नॉलेज व्हाट एवर वी हैव, कॉरोशन मीन्स व्हाट वी थिंक कॉरोशन इज रस्टिंग ऑफ ए मेटल। ओके, इफ एनी मेटल विल गेट रस्टेड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज कॉरोशन। एज पर अवर जनरल नॉलेज विल बी थिंकिंग लाइकवाइज। ओके, but as per the textbook definition, what is the meaning of the term corrosion? Corrosion means gradual deterioration of a metal is called as corrosion. Gradual destruction or deterioration of a metal is called as corrosion. Okay, how does this corrosion occurs? Let us see now. And what are the causes of this corrosion? Okay, causes of corrosion is again classified into two different types. Okay, what are the causes of corrosion? They are, first one is native state. And then second one is combined state. What are these native state and combined state? The existence of metals in the nature. How does the metals will exist in the nature? In what form? Okay, that forms states are called as native state or combined state. These are of two types. Okay, if it is a native state. Okay, for example, we can consider metals like Au. Au is what? Gold, silver, bronze. Okay, likewise, like these examples, we can call them as, these all metals are called as noble metals or else inert metals. They never ever reacts with any other components existing in the environment. Okay, because of that reason, we'll called these metals as noble metals or inert metals. Okay, they will exist in the nature as it is. They never ever get impure. They never ever get reacts with other components in the nature. Okay, because of that reason we'll be calling them as native state elements, native state metals. Okay, next, if you see the combined state, the name itself have the meaning of it. What it is? Combined. It is combined with any other chemical components and it will exist in the nature likewise. For example, let us take Fe2O3, ZnO, likewise ZnO2, MnO2, likewise if you take any compound, if you see here, Fe is a metal here. Metal is being existed combined with the three molecules of oxygen. Okay, so that means it is what? It is in the state of combined state. If you see the zinc also here, zinc also combined with the oxygen and it is existing in the form of combined state. Okay, so these are the examples of native and combined state. Native means their original nature will be in the form of a pure form. They never ever get reacts with any other components. Okay, such a state is called as native state. And combined state means the original metals, they will get able to stable by reacting with the another elements in the environment. Okay, they are FeO2, ZnO, likewise. Okay, these are the examples. Okay, and these are the most stable ones. These are also most stable ones. They exist in the universe in the stable nature. Okay, and these two are the causes of corrosion. Let us see what is a general phenomenon. How does corrosion occurs in the nature? Okay, how does corrosion occurs? Corrosion, everybody knows corrosion occurs to the metals only, right? So how does corrosion occurs? For example, let us consider it as a pure form of a metal. Let us consider it is a pure form of a metal. Okay, pure form of a metal is always having high energy. metal always have higher energy. Why? Because it is a pure metal, it contains high energy, but it is not that much stable, it is unstable. Okay, a pure form of a metal contains high energy, but it will not a stable. Okay, because of this unstable nature only, it will get affected to the corrosion. Okay, whatever the materials or metals, okay, whatever the chemical components existing in the nature, everybody requires stability. Okay, even metals also require some stability in the nature. Okay, whenever it wants to get stable, okay, they will convert in the form of ores. Okay, if any metal reacts with chemical components existing in the nature, and they will convert in the form of ores. Okay, what are the ores? Ores are the impure form of a metal. Ores are impure form of metal. We can also say it as combined state. Okay, so let's consider it as metal oxide. Metal has been converted to stable form in the form of metal oxide. Okay, and this is stable form of the metal, and it contains low energy. Contains low energy. Energy is being decreased. High energy to low energy. Okay. So what's happening here? Energy is being decreased. There is some loss of energy occurs. Okay. If anything is losing. Okay. Such process is called as what? We can call, as per the electrochemistry, we will be calling it as, if any lose of electrons, we will call as oxidation process. Here also we will consider it as same. Okay. If anything will loses energy, we will call it as oxidation process. This metal will get oxidized to give metal oxide. Okay, you can see the differences between these two diagrams. Here I gave only for the metal, I gave only small a gap inside it. There is no gap. If you see this, there is a large gap inside it. Okay, and because it is impure and have low energy, okay, it has been reacted with environmental gas like oxygen. Metal has been reacted with oxygen to give metal oxide. Okay, metal has been oxidized to give metal oxide compound. Okay, this is the impure form of a metal. Okay, so this is a stable form of a metal. Okay, why will be calling it as a stable form of a metal? Why? Because this is a ore existing in the universe. Okay, any metal, they are existing in the universe, means they will be exist in the form of ores. Okay, it is an impure form and it is a pure form. Okay, there is a loss of energy from a pure metal to a lower energy. That process is called as oxidation. Okay, corrosion. How does corrosion happens? Corrosion happens because of oxidation. If any metal get oxidized, it will get affected to the corrosion. Okay, meanwhile they get gradually destructed or deteriorated, and it will get destroyed after some time. Like this, it will loses its energy. Okay, that process is called as oxidation, losing of energy. Okay, by losing of energy or else gradual destruction of a metal is called as corrosion. Okay, in case if you want to convert this metal oxide into a pure form of metal, okay, conversion of these will be reduction process. Okay, reduction process, or else we can say it as metallurgy. Metallurgy, we also can call it as metallurgy. Conversion of ore into easily available a metal in the earth crust is ore. We'll be converting this ore into pure form of a metal by the process of reduction. Okay, it is also called as metallurgy. Conversion of impure form of the metal into pure form of the metal is called as metallurgy. Okay, so this reduction process means actually what we say, gaining of energy. Okay, oxidation means losing of energy, reduction means gaining of energy. Okay, gaining of electrons as per the electrochemistry. Okay, so here it is being converted into low energy into high energy. That means it is being gaining some amount of energy. If you want to write here, it is higher energy, it is lower energy, means energy plus energy we can write. Okay, energy has been lost by this. If you want to add this amount of energy with this, again, such process is called as reduction, then we would be able to get pure form of the matter. Okay, now let us see a general equation. Okay, how does metal will get corroded? As per the chemical equation, let's see how does metal will get corroded. After corrosion of metal, what is the background reaction happens during corrosion? Let us see the general equation. Okay, for example, let us consider iron is being affected to corrosion. Okay, so for example, if you take corrosion, let us take two compound, two molecules of iron, and it is being affected to the oxygen present in the environment. Okay, so let us take 3/2 O2. That means what it is? 3/2 O2 means what? 3 molecules of oxygen we are taking here. Okay, so gives rise to oxidation. Okay, this iron is being corroded because of oxygen present in the environment, and it is being oxidized. Okay, if it will get oxidized, what happens? It will get affected to the corrosion. Okay, how does it will get converted into Fe2O3? Okay, Fe2O3 will converts into metal oxide, as you have seen here. Here M is a pure form of a metal, iron, Fe. It is being converted into metal oxide. That is, you can consider it as iron oxide, Fe2O3. Okay, metal has been converted into metal oxide. Okay, this is a general equation. Here we have to add water molecules also. X number of water molecules also, in the presence of X number of water molecules, and oxygen will get reacts with iron, will get oxidized to give Fe2O3 dot X number of water molecules. Okay, this is what happens in the background when an iron will get affected to corrosion. Okay, this is the basic fundamental scenario of how the corrosion is occurring in the nature. Okay, now let us see what are the different theories of corrosion. Okay, there are two different theories of corrosion are there. Let us see those two theories now. Let's see theories of corrosion. Okay, there are two theories of corrosion are there. Theories, or else we can call it as classification also. Theories of corrosion or classification of corrosions. What are they? First one is dry corrosion or chemical corrosion. Dry corrosion or chemical corrosion. Second one is wet or electrochemical corrosion. Wet or electrochemical corrosion. These are the two classifications of corrosion. What is the dry corrosion or chemical corrosion? The name itself have the meaning of it. What it is? Dry means in the dry condition corrosion happens. Wet means during wet condition a corrosion happens. It is also called as electrochemical and chemical corrosion. Okay, now let us see the one example each. Okay, how does dry corrosion happens, how does wet corrosion happens, and its theories. Okay, so first let us see dry corrosion in the presence of oxidation. Okay, corrosion by oxygen or oxidation corrosion. Let's see one example. A okay, corrosion by oxidation or oxygen, and let us see electrochemical corrosion with hydrogen corrosion. Hydrogen or else during hydrogen corrosion there must be some moisture also in the air. In the presence of water molecules, the corrosion happens. Corrosion, oxidation or oxygen corrosion, oxygen corrosion, and the next one is hydrogen corrosion. Let us see the examples for oxygen corrosion as well as hydrogen corrosion now. What is dry corrosion?